I'm putting in these baffles just for the heck of it, because, you know, I like bending stuff with my new brake back there. And plus, it might actually help me see with this shiny polished surface, you know, the gas level. But so yeah, I'm going to zip it up. It's gone well. That flip top cap is cast aluminum, and you know, it was a little nasty, but it turned out well enough. That bead's a little fatty, but I'm on it. And you know, I've never welded in a bung on these aluminum jobs before, and you know, this is what I decided on, to go with a motorcycle style that has the reserve ability. In case I ever run out of gas, I'll have reserve on tap, and I'll use this as my gas filter as well. I won't use filter, but had a nice elbow, so I'll come from underneath there. Otherwise, I was thinking about just punching one in here and coming right out the front, but nah, this'll do. Okay, so we're getting ready to zip this baby up, and you can probably see the tack up and the fit up is real good, because, you know, I'm a novice. I want to make sure everything goes well, and I'm going to use a triangular wave on this Everlast machine I have. It's kind of a cheater method, but you know, this aluminum, you can turn it into soup if you overheat it, and the metal can drop out on you. So I kind of rely on the triangular wave on this lighter aluminum. So that's what I'm going to be using. It makes a nice narrow bead, which I like too. And I've got the Hertz turned up to about 200 AC frequency. So, you know, it'll sound like a bumblebee, but that's what I'm going for. A real defined, penetrating kind of a bead that doesn't, you know, melt everything on both sides. So we'll see how it goes. I'm sure it'll go okay. I've got 36 inches of filler here. I might be able to make this whole bead. Hopefully I won't dip any in the puddle and have to stop and all that stuff. So Okay, there it is. Amateur TIG welding. But yeah, it went well. I'll show you. And there's the bead I was going for, you know, just nipping that edge there and, you know, not going over, but getting right up to it. And it looks like it did. I really dig that triangular wave. You know, it's really helpful to a newbie like me with this stuff, because like I said, this aluminum, if you overheat it, it can drop out on you and, you know, you got a mess. And that triangular wave really helps really keep the heat constrained. Okay, and here it is, all finished, all single pass on all the seams. It went well, and I've given it a brushed finish. I don't like that polished mirror look, so you know, and I was tempted to actually take the flap disc on the angle grinder and you know, brush and smooth out the tops of the beads here. Not because they're bad or anything, they look quite good, but I have always thought, you know, on something a little more decorative, that a welding bead, you know, reminds me of Frankenstein. So I would normally knock these ripples off and, you know, kind of match the brush metal finish a little better that way. And but no, this is a gas tank. It's my first one, so I'm going to leave well enough alone. All the metal deposition, I don't want to remove any of that and keep the integrity of these seams real good. Other than that, triangle wave on all the seams, except down here. This joint could tolerate the heat input more, and I used a thicker filler, 3/32 filler. So, you know, you can see it's just a fatter, bigger toe-in, side-to-side bead, and, you know, that's good. It's, you know, that's, if there's going to be a leak, it might be down in these corners and stuff. So before I made these two pieces together, I did put a heavy bead on the inside of these corners and on all of these joints in the corners and these points. I was careful not to leave a crater crack, you know, so there's a pretty good little knuckle on all of these points here. That's where you'll get a crack. If you have a crater left behind, and that's where they'll start from. But now, it all looks good. It's been pressure tested with water and air. And